is the support we have got from DBT, Star College Scheme, in which the non-recurring grant we have to utilize by September 2021, and the recurring grant of 3 lakhs each, which has to be consumed each year. This is the annual budget we had proposed for 2020-21 grant batch financial year, which we would like, which we would do our best to consume this particular year. This is the list of proposed practicals. Since we were covering all the practicals which were included in the syllabus during our lab sessions, we had proposed 36 new practicals under this Star College scheme to bridge up a gap between the theory and the practicals of that particular year. The grant has been utilized to purchase the new equipment and the multiple copies of the existing equipment. We have planned it out in such a way that we have allocated 6 practicals for each semester. This would be carried out in addition to the practicals which are offered by the university. All the practicals will be conducted by all the students which are present, and the teachers involved are those teachers which have already taken those classes. With the arrival of new equipments, our student to instrument ratio will come as low as 3:1, which was initially as 14:1. I'll share with. I'll share the practicals which will be conducted under DBT Star College scheme. This is the proposed list of practicals for each semester. Okay, there we go. As per second thing, equipments which has to be procured, we had finalized the equipments by 15th of September, and the order has been placed to the vendors. Purchase order was partially placed, and the we were told that it would be delivered today, but due to meeting, we had to postpone it till tomorrow. We have made the partial payment regarding this order. Allocation of projects. We had proposed 6 projects for each of the classes, 5 or 6 projects for each of the classes. We have made the group, of 4 students each for all the classes, and the teachers, they have been, the faculty members, they have been allotted the students regarding these projects. And the number of student and teacher ratio that has been taken as 1. Certain students, the groups, they would be doing the practical, those projects in first semester, and other students, they would be doing those practicals in second semester. In the next semester, even and odd semesters, we have divided the students so that the practicals can be done by most number of students. Workshop and seminars. Since it is the time of COVID-19 and lockdown, we are doing our best to cover up maximum number of seminars, or not workshops and seminars, but certain activities and webinars we are conducting, and as per the timelines. Industrial visit, we were already in talk with one of the cattle feed plant, but they wanted the students, they should undergo PCR test. So during this lockdown, that couldn't be arranged, and we couldn't go in with that, and definitely we would be carrying it forward for the students in the next session. The activities which were performed, instead, these are the first in the month of September that was done for BSc first year, which was a poster making activity. During this activity, the students, they were acquainted with the safety measures that should be utilized in the laboratory and the hazards of the chemicals. They were given a Zoom meeting regarding the safety symbols which are on the glass bottles of the chemicals, and they were asked to prepare the charts accordingly. The students, they explored the internets and they prepared the charts regarding safety symbols in the laboratories and the symbols on the chemical reagent bottles. And we gave them the Google form on which they attached those files, and we have the record of that. The next activity, that was an on-screen acid-based titration. The link for the same was provided through Royal Society of Chemistry, and it was an introduction regarding titrations which was given to the BSc second year students. And during this, they had to share with us the lab report. This is the lab report. With this lab report, they came to know about what are the titrations, what are the different steps involved during acid-based titration. They could know how to do the weighing. They could also know how to prepare the standard solution. They could read the burette readings with the meniscus, lower meniscus and higher meniscus, and they could write it down. And they could also calculate the strength of the solutions.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Then one activity that was carried on for BSc final year students, that was preparation of acetanilide through conventional and green methods. In this activity, the students, they were asked to explore the internet, to go through the procedures which were used to prepare the acetanilide. We would be taking this activity forward by using the preparation of acetanilide using sonicator. So that is the proposed activity which would be done when the students, they are coming back to the colleges. Then this is one of the activities which we have taken up, the students, they have taken up for BSc first year, that was recrystallization of sugar. Since the lockdown continues and the students, they are given the activities which they can perform at home, and they were given a week's time for performing these activities. In this activity, they were asked to, they were given the procedures to carry out the crystallization process of sugar at the home, and they had to click the pics of the day one, day two, when the crystals, they appear, and send it to us through a Google form, either as a PDF, or they could share with us the pics of the and the students, they have already acknowledged that they could understand.
Sorry to interrupt, the students are supposed to do these at home, or how do they do? Or your college is open?
No, ma'am, they are doing it at home.
Okay.
So they are doing it at home using the things which is available at home. Because it was crystallization of sugar, so sugar was available at home. And they just had to heat up, prepare the saturated solution, and then they had to note down the crystals. It took 3 to 4 days for the students to complete this process. Then there was one activity which the students were asked to do, that was preparation of soap samples. They were given the procedure to prepare the soap samples with the ingredients which they were having at home, that is oil. Then they were asked to take up caustic soda. They were asked to use aloe vera, rose petals, or lime for the fragrance purposes. Through this process, they understood the concept of sponification. And this is the pic of the PDF files, yeah, JPGs, which they have shared with us. They were also asked to compare the foaming capacity of various samples which they have prepared, or the soaps which they already had at their home. Then this was the final year activity, was to prepare the sample of furniture polish using vinegar, turpentine oil, methyl spirit, and linseed oil. So students, they have prepared it at their home with the ingredients which are the, which they already had. And similarly, prepare a shampoo, which was again with the ingredients they had at home. Again, they learned the concept of spoonification. Then this is the faculty improvement. These are the webinars or the orientation programs which this teachers they have been attending from this particular session, that is April 2022 till now. This activity, we were since the extension lectures they couldn't be conducted, so we are conducting the webinars during this this session. The webinar, the first webinar, which was conducted by Dr. J. Nagendra Babu, Center of Chemical Sciences, Central University of Punjab, Bathinda. This was on 24th September 2020. And around 97 students, they participated in this, on this Google Meet platform. 16 faculty members were also benefited during this. This was conducted about semi-volatile organic compounds in ambient atmosphere. These are the clippings and glimpses of those of that webinar. Another webinar we conducted in the month of October, that was on 29th of October, on the role of chemistry in our lives. This was one of the best webinars which I have ever attended. This was by Dr. Mohammad Yusuf, from a professor from Department of Chemistry, Punjab University, Patiala. Again, on Google Meet platform, number of students which were involved in this was 89 and 12 faculty members. These are the glimpses of the webinar. Another webinar we had conducted on 7th of November this month, about enzymes and coenzymes and their roles in biological reactions. This was conducted, the resource person for this was Dr. Aman Bhalla, Department of Chemistry, Punjab University, Chandigarh, again on the Google Meet. 56 students, they had participated, and 8 faculty members had participated on this. These are the glimpses. This was the training of lab manpower. A non-teaching faculty member, Mr. Pankaj Kumar, he was trained. He underwent 1 month training program in MS Office and MS Word, MS Word and MS Excel in computers. Then impact of Star College scheme. Definitely, we had floated some. We are floating the. About the webinars which we are conducting, and we had also quoted some news about the Star College scheme, due to which we feel that the students, they were eager to take admission in the first year course, and the department, they have been it has been very helpful, this scheme that has been very helpful for the department, since we are being equipped with multiple copies of the instruments, so it will be easy for us to and even for the students to take up the same procedures and to note down the readings at the same time. The department that is being established with a library for the students as well as for the faculty members. We are upgrading our labs regarding glassware and chemicals, and we expect sufficient and efficient use of chemicals thereafter. The budget expenditure we have done till now is rupees 2000 that has been paid as honorarium to the resource persons of the webinar. Since one of our resource person, he has denied the payment, so we couldn't make that another payment. And another rupees 5699 has been consumed against contingency. We have also made a payment of rupees 4 lakh as advance to the one of the vendors who will be delivering the equipments tomorrow morning against the purchase order of 10,1549. Then comparative charts for books, glassware and chemicals, they are done. Vendors, they have been shortlisted and most probably will be placing an order in the next week. The future activities we wish to take up for the Department of Chemistry are an extension lecture. If the things are okay, then we would definitely like to organize the lecture offline by Dr. Harish Chopra, who will be delivering a lecture for green chemistry, and Dr. Panesar, who will be delivering a lecture for adulteration of food. They had to take a lecture in October month, but due to their busy schedule, they couldn't spare the time. And now they have we are waiting for their consent to take up the lecture in November, which they have given us on the telephone. Then hands-on training, we would be going in with preparation of home-based cosmetics, which will be the activity of the month of November. And model making and presentation through virtual mode. If the in this case, if the students, they are not present. Although we are trying to, our college that is trying to go in with offline mode for the 50% with 50% attendance of the students. And then faculty development program, which will be carried out in the December, and inter-college quiz competition, which is again in the month of December. That's
Dr.
all.
Okay, it was over. I just wanted to ask a quick question. How is your college planning to have an offline mode with 50% students? That means like in a class of 30, 15 students will come today and the rest 15 will come next day, or they will be like two periods of the same lecture, or what way?
Ma'am, we are planning to go up with the students which will be would be coming, 50% students, they would be taking up one day, and another day they, the other 50% students, they would be coming. And we are planning to go in with the practical session similarly with a grouping of students, not more than 15.
Essentially, you will be repeating what you have taught the first day again to the students the next day in the second batch.
Ma'am, along with the first batch, we would also be taking a Zoom meet. Since we have conducted a few practicals regarding salt analysis on the Zoom meet. So we have already given an outline to the students regarding how to conduct the experiment, how to go in with the preliminary tests and all. So we would be taking both online and offline mode. The Zoom meeting will still be on when half of the students they would be conducting, and the other day, students they would be conducting the same experiment along with a certain new part.
Okay, that only happens if the college is open. But in case the colleges are not opening for some more time, which is, and I think that would be a better option, because taking into consideration the present scenario, it is okay to be more safe than be sorry. The thing is that you could well define these headings where you say model making presentation. It will be nice if you give some theme-based model making or presentations to the students rather than leaving it open-ended for them to decide, and then it becomes very basic and sometimes the students... One more thing that you can add is a journal club, because as of now, you cannot have projects online. This whole session, we feel, has been wasted. But still, you can inculcate the students with the habit of having a journal club. So you give them a topic, ask them to prepare it online from their homes, and then give a presentation online. So that will also develop the habit of reading papers, understanding what is research methodology, what is the meaning of hypothesis, and that will also try to instigate the curiosity as well as their interest in science, which is the primary focus of the scheme. This year, because we all know we are tied up at homes and we can't impart the way it was planned, because you had proposed 36 new practicals, which of course you would not be able to do it in the present scenario. So we should try to make alternate use of the resources that has been given to you under STAR. Another thing which you can do is that rather than having webinars and extension lectures from people who are nearby only, you should also find some established scientists or professors from universities other than those of Punjab. Get in touch with them so that the students are also exposed to a wider degree of, you can say, they get to know what is happening elsewhere.
Elsewhere.
So, with this, I think, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for the suggestions. We will definitely go in with that.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. To present the Department of Physics, now I would like to Dr. Gurpreet Singh, HOD and Scheme Coordinator Physics.
Hello, good morning to all of you. Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good morning to all of you. Myself, Dr. Gurpreet Singh, is presenting before you the activities of the Department of Physics under DBT STAR College Scheme. The Department of Physics was established in 1969-70, and the college was established. The vision of the department is to strive continuously in pursuit of excellence and to identify practical applications of physics for the betterment of society. So regarding curricular aspects of the department, the department offers the two courses, this is the faculty profile. There are two permanent faculty members, myself and Dr. Gurvinder Singh Mann, and two contract faculty, Harpreet Kaur Brad and Dr. Vikas Dukal. These are two laboratory staff members, Mr. Rakesh and Mr. Deepak. So regarding student strength, this is the number of students from 2018 to 2020. This is the male-female ratio of the department for BSc 1, 2 and 3. So regarding the progress report of the English department under DBT STAR College scheme, so these are the list of new practicals which has been introduced in the department as prescribed by the university, which were earlier could not be conducted earlier due to lack of equipments. So these are the experiments. So out of these 17 experiments, we are in the process of procuring 13 experiments, and we are in the process of procuring 13 experiments because the 14, 15, 16 and 17 number experiments could not be procured due to costly instruments, that is more than 1 lakh. So these are energy resolution using calibration and scintillation counter. And so these are basically experiments which are based upon scintillation counter, which cost more than 1 lakh. So that is why it could not be purchased. So, in addition to these 13 experiments, we are in the process of establishing an innovation hub where 25 experiments will be demonstrated to the students. So, these are the 25 experiments which will be demonstrated to students in the lab. So, these are the number of lists of projects which have been allocated to the students. That is characteristics of photocell, battery level indicator, characteristics of inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier, survey of mobile signal strength, thermoelectric refrigerators, G-factor, measurement of radius of variation, analysis of purity of water with laser. So we have allotted a number of projects to the students by making groups. So regarding lectures and webinars organized by department, on September 21 and 22, we organized importance of using ICT in teaching and learning in the times of pandemic and using virtual labs for understanding important concepts in physics. Professor P.K. Aluwalia from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla, and Dr. Sapna Sharma, Associate Professor, Department of Physics, St. Bede's College, Shimla, both of them delivered lecture on importance of using ICT in teaching and learning in the times of pandemic and using virtual labs for understanding important concepts in physics. So, a total of 82 participants attended the webinar. And students enjoyed this webinar because in this time of pandemic, when nobody can attend the offline practical training, they can use virtual labs for understanding important concepts in physics. So an interdisciplinary talk was held on September 26th on the topic bioinformatics, an ocean of opportunity to leverage. So Dr. Felix Past, Associate Professor, Central University of Punjab, Bathinda, he delivered this talk on bioinformatics. The Department of Biology and Physics organized this event on 26 September, in which a total of 208 participants attended, and this was also streamed live on YouTube. So regarding his seminar on radiation exposure and health effects, Dr. Sandeep Kansal, Professor, Department of Physics, MRS, Maharaj Ranjit Singh, Punjab Technical University, Bathinda, delivered a lecture on radiation exposure.
Please come close to the mic, Dr. Gurpreet, so that we can hear you. Your voice is so feeble.
On 10th October, okay, madam, okay.
Yes,
on
better.
October 2020 via Google Meet. So a total of 120 participants attended the webinar. So, we also organized an online poster making competition on the theme of India's nuclear and space program. So, the aim of the activity performed on 15th October was to acquaint students with the contribution of Dr. Kalam, who made towards India's achievement in the field of nuclear and space technology. So, a total of 87 registrations were received from across the country. So out of all the competitive entries, the best three were selected for cash prize of rupees 500 each. These are some of the selected posters in the next slide, and e-certificates were awarded to all the participants. So these were the selected posters for online poster making competition. So the FIP attended by the faculty members, these are the number of FIPs attended by the various faculty members, by me, Dr. Gurvinder Singh Mann, and Harpreet Kaur and Vikas Dugal. So regarding training of lab manpower, our lab assistant, Mr. Deepak and Mr. Rakesh of the department were given 15 rate computer training in MS Office by the Department of Computer Science, DAV College, Bathinda. So the impact of the Star College scheme is we will be able to enhance quality of practical training after introducing new experiments that could not be performed earlier due to non-availability of equipments. So we are procuring multiple copies of basic equipments like xenodiode, GM counter, BH curve, polarimeter, spectrometer, which will help us in reducing student to equipment ratio. The students have been encouraged to opt for minor projects along with the regular classroom teaching. So regarding the budget expenditure, recurring grant of 17,110 has been spent on the repair of instruments of the lab. The recurring grant of ₹9,500 has been spent as remuneration to resource persons for the webinars. And regarding the non-recurring grant of 10 lakhs, we are in the process of purchasing equipments for which purchase order has already been submitted to the DBT office of the college. Regarding the future activity, we are organizing practical demonstration of innovative experiments. Dr. YK Vijay, who is President and Vice Chancellor Vivekananda Global University, Jaipur, who will be coming to this to the college whenever the COVID-19 situation will improve, and who will demonstrate 25 experiments to the students. So, and the other is the execution of projects which have been allotted to the students. So depending upon the COVID-19 situation, hands-on practical training to students in new innovative experiments, industrial visit to thermal power plant, Bathinda, and some webinars and seminars will also be organized. Thank you. Over to Dr.
Hello. Hello. Thank you, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Ma'am, any query and question regarding this presentation? I want to share with you that Dr. B.S. Sandhu has another engagement at 12. So, before my presentation, I want to invite Dr. B.S. Sandhu to give suggestions or and their valuable advices for us. Over to Dr. B.S.
Thank you, Dr. Mann. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So my advice is that first to enhance the strength in the BSc, make efforts to enhance the strength in BSc, because the number of students who are opting BSc non-medical, as per the slides given by Dr. Gurpreet, that is on the decline side. So make special efforts for that one. Then my second suggestion is that as far as the curriculum of university is concerned, so in BSc final, you must have the experiment related to the scintillation spectrometer. And Dr. Gurpreet has pointed out that the price of each of the spectrometer is more than 1 lakh. No doubt the actual price will come out to be near between 4 to 4.5 lakh.
Yes,
so have special arrangement for that one before the students come to the university. So they must have performed experiments related to the scintillation spectrometer. Then I will also advise you to organize quiz for the students, especially among the schools. For example, the plus one and plus two schools which are located in your region. So have quiz contest there, or invite the students to your institute and have the quiz contest, or have the quiz contests on the webinar. Similarly, I will also advise that the students must be exposed to whatever the number of students who are doing graduation at your college, they must be exposed, or you should organize their visits if possible either to the Science City at Kapurthala, or you can have visit to the other institutes maybe of national importance as well as the state importance. Like in the universities, you can show them, for example, your students are welcome in our department. They will get to know that what type of research work we are going on and how that research work is valuable to the society. They will see the instrumentation infrastructure involved here. So especially for Punjab University Patiala Physics Department or Punjab University Chandigarh Physics Department. Similarly, if you can arrange a short tour for the group, number of group students, maybe between number maybe 10 to 15 to the national institute like Bhabha Atomic Research Center or Inter-University Accelerator Center at New Delhi, or you can simply have the RRCAT, Raja Ramanna Center for Advanced Technology in Indore. So you may also involve their scientists to deliver the webinar here. I can recommend you the name. They will be definitely eager to give the in the webinar the presentation related to the whatever the activities you require, either at the plus one, plus two level or at the graduation level. So these are my some suggestions for the institute.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable suggestions. So these suggestions will help us in future activities also. So as far as sir, you have pointed out the Dr. Gurpreet sir's presentation, I think he told that the cost of The scintillation counter is more than 4 lakh.
Between 4 and 4.5 lakh.
Yes, sir.
So that is a part of the curriculum of BSc third year.
Yes, sir. Bilkul. It has mentioned in the syllabus, and we are always trying from since I joined this college in 2004. We are always requesting to the chair that we need these instrument. With this instrument, we can perform three to four experiments, which are the most important part of our physics laboratory. But due to lack of funds, and even now we get the grant, but in this grant there is a limit on the purchase of equipment more than 1 lakh. With special permission, we can purchase up to 3 lakh and apparatus of 3 lakh. But that single apparatus costs more than that, thus we skip that. In future, we are trying for another agency or to get this grant, and we definitely get this equipment. But in the present scenario, there is a simulation lab of scintillation counter. We have tried, and I personally take its training and Rad Lab.
By interrupting you, I can simply say that because our Indian students, they have to compete at the globe level.
Yes.
So what atomic research type institution, they require that the students at the post graduation level must be exposed to this type of instrumentation, and the students at the graduation level, they demand that they at least they must be exposed to these scintillation counters. So that is an essential part of the curriculum at the UGC level also.
Yes, sir. Yes. So we will try our best to purchase as soon as possible the scintillation counter, sir. And as far as visits of Punjab University Patiala and Punjab University, when the situation become normal, we definitely plan, and we have already planned to bring our students to explore the research labs, to visits the sophisticated instrumentation lab at Punjab University Science City. So
thanks now the other team is ready because that is the selection committee meeting, so I have to
be present. Thank you so much. Now this is my turn to present overall presentation of the DBT. I didn't take much time. Please wait. I am sharing my screen. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So I don't repeat the same slides that already shown by my colleagues. This is our first presentation, and this is the composition of advisory committee that already explained in the beginning. So I skip these presentation slides. So this is a brief introduction about Star College scheme. So Department of Biotechnology, DBT, Ministry of Science and Technology.
Dr. Nand?
Yes, ma'am.
Dr. Nand, you can skip the description of Star College scheme. Okay, this ma'am. Is not for us.
My the point here is to show only this point. That is
okay.
our college is the only college of the Bathinda Faridkot region awarded by this scheme. So we have
okay.
we have in our region there are 13 colleges and 4 universities, and we are the first among that to get this scheme. That is the brief introduction about this slide. So I can skip the objectives also, ma'am. So these are the objectives.
Yes, please.
Okay. So
you can only tell your specific objectives if you want, not the general objectives of the Star College
scheme. Okay, ma'am. Okay, thank you. So
yeah, because all these details are with us.
Yes. So this is the order, and in this grant we received, we get non-recurring grant of that is I think I have to skip this slide also. So there is some confusion that I want to clarify about this travel grant that is mentoring, monitoring and site visit. So that will be clarified at the end of this presentation. So communication with the DBT. So we have informed about the transfer of our principal to the department. So communicated the signed agreement, that is memorandum of understanding with the department. So these are the committees that have been constituted for the implementation of the Star College scheme. So this financial matter committee and DBT purchase committee and DBT office. So this is our outlook of our departments. We have updated the signboards and display the objectives of the DBT before the physics and chemistry labs. So this is the tentative timeline of our activities before COVID-19 for each department. So we have planned and submitted the proposal with this timeline. So for the first year proposal, so there are these are the activities that we have planned. So from these activities, as in this, we are in this frame of time from July to December. So we have already placed the purchase order for the equipments. So workshops, there is no workshop in this first semester. So and training program for students, we have planned training program in the next semester. So and extension lectures, instead of extension lectures, we are holding webinars. So that we are have doing, and industrial visit have already planned in the next semester. So national conference and seminar that we have planned in the third year, and additional practical projects and the project works that we have also allotted to the students, and many of the students are performing it. So these pending activities in the next semester will be performed soon. So work done after receiving the Star College scheme, purchase order of equipments for both departments have been placed, repair of old instruments and equipments, sign boards comprising objective of DBT College Star College scheme have been installed in front of labs. Computer training have been provided to our lab staffs. And for enriching departmental libraries, purchase order of multiple copies of 49 books with multiple copies also have been placed. 27 for chemistry and 22 for physics department. Minor projects have been assigned to the students as described in the presentation by the departmental coordinators. Organized an online training program to implementation of the Star College scheme by Dr. Rajiv Khoslaji. He is also present in this platform. So on the 28th of August, we got the training, brief training about how to implement this Star College scheme as the due to present scenario, nothing can be done physically. Thus, he guided us how to implement, because sir has a wide experience in this field, and his college has got star status under his stewardship. So he has also helped us in the framing of our proposal. So he guided us in a very good manner. So he is only a phone call away from us. Whenever we meet some, face some problem, we call him and he suggests how to solve it. So thank you, sir. And organized many webinars for UG science students, organized an online poster making competition, which is the outreach activity also, prepared SOPs for practicals that have not performed due to lack of funds, and motivated students to join workshops, webinars organized by other colleges also. Activities organized by physics department, faculty training, that is Star College of Star College scheme, how to implement it, that I have already explained in previous slide by Dr. Rajiv Khosla. training of Microsoft Excel and by Dr. P.K. Aluwalia ji. Student training of virtual labs developed by Ministry of MHRD as a V-Lab to do many practicals of undergraduate level by developed by MHRD in collaboration with IITs. So that training was provided by Dr. Sapna Sharma. So the benefit of this training will be given to students as well as to staff. Interdisciplinary webinar on bioinformatics by Dr. Felix Bast of Central University of Punjab, Bathinda, and interdisciplinary webinar on radiation exposure and health effects by Dr. Sandeep Kansal of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, Punjab Technical University, Bathinda. Outreach activity, that is virtual poster making competition, that was held on 15th of October. Activities organized by Department of Chemistry. Webinars on semi-volatile that have by Dr. J.N. Babu. Role of chemistry in our lives by Dr. Muhammad Yusuf of Punjabi University Patiala. And interdisciplinary webinar on enzymes coenzymes and their role in biological reactions by Dr. Aman Bhalla of Punjab University, Chandigarh. So training of lab manpower on MS Word and MS Excel for 1 month training of their non-teaching staff. So these are
what kind of training was sorry, Dr.
Yes,
ma'am. What kind of training was imparted for this lab?
Yes, ma'am.
You said. Just go to your previous slide.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what kind of this lab manpower, what does it mean?
Actually, lab manpower is the term that we taken from the DBT proposal. This is for the non-teaching staff or the lab assistants. So during this lockdown time, as the labs are free and our college is open and we came to the college where no students is there, our lab staff is free. Then we approach to our Department of Computer Science to give some training to our lab staff so that they become computer savvy or they will use helpful us in future activities. This is the meaning of lab manpower. Okay, ma'am? Can I continue?
Yes, please, sir.
Okay. So projects for students, interdepartmental projects, water quality survey of the region, survey of mobile signal strength, physics of kitchen, and various activities have been planned that the students can perform at their home due to the present scenario. Measurement of thickness of hair with the laser, measurement of exhalation due to gravity at home, investigation of a specific absorption rate for various mobile phone sets available at home, effectiveness of physics practicals with virtual labs, thermocouple as a temperature sensor, battery eliminator, rectifiers used in the mobile charger, study of electrochemical cells, characteristics of photo cells, and measurement of Planck's constant. So the in chemistry department, separation of amino acids, detection of ions and compounds present in toothpaste and foodstuffs, analysis of hair dyes for toxicity, analysis of agricultural soils, detection of insecticides and pesticides in various fruits and vegetables, synthesis and applications of nanoparticles, green versus conventional synthesis, synthesis of biodegradable polymers, and human-friendly cosmetics. But these activities will be possible if the COVID-19 situation will improve. So we hope it will improve as the colleges are going to open as already described in the 50% mode. So these are the Yes, ma'am.
I'm interrupting you. You don't have to read out all the names of these projects and practicals which you have formalized for conducting with the students. One thing that you could have done is that made it more clear by telling what projects would be done by which year students, which is not clear in your slides.
That has already explained by Dr. Gurpreet, and I will show in the next slide also the how we have planned the grouping of students for doing the projects and what are projects allotted to them. So that has already in the next slide.
Can you come straight to that slide?
Okay. So these are the list of projects, ma'am, that we have devised for a physics department. So can I read all the projects? So characteristics of photocells.
No, this is fine. Don't read them. We can see them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I come to the
next slide.
Yes. So the list is here. I have attached it's hyperlinked. So this is the physics department for the Department of Physics. So it takes time to open. It is hyperlinked to it. So is it visible?
Yeah, we are trying to read, but okay, it's actually not very clear.
I am enlarging it.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have planned the groups by taking students from as four students in a group and two students from single class, that is for BSc 1, two students from BSc 1, one from BSc 2 and one from BSc 3. Yes.
And can you explain why you have taken students from BSc 1, BSc 2, BSc 3 in one single group? Yes. I mean, their level of understanding would be very different.
No,
but the degree of complexity of the projects or experiments would also be very different pertaining to these different year students.
So
it would have been better if you would have clubbed the same year students together. Like BSc 1, may say 4 students leke club karte, or BSc 2 ke alag club karte. Because आप BSc 1 को जो प्रोजेक्ट कराओगे वो BSc 3 वालों के लिए तो बहुत ही बेसिक हो जाएगा ना
जी एक्चुअली मैम एक्चुअली यू आर राइट बिल्कुल थोड़ा सजेशन ठीक है सर मैम वी विल एक्सेप्ट इट बट द रीजन बिहाइंड इट इज दैट वी एज वी आर इन द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ आवर दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स सो BSc फाइनल ईयर स्टूडेंट इज आल्सो एज न्यू टू दिस प्रोजेक्ट्स एज BSc 1 स्टूडेंट BSc फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट So that means we have planned the new projects. So
Dr. Barunga is saying the level of understanding of these three students will be different level. So it will be appropriate to group them in their respective years.
Okay, then we will change it according to your suggestion.
I would further clarify जो BSc 1 में थ्योरी में पढ़ाया जाता है उसी के अकॉर्डिंग आप उनको प्रोजेक्ट्स बनवाओगे राइट फाइनल ईयर में जो थ्योरी में पढ़वाया जाता है उसी के हिसाब से आप उनके लिए प्रोजेक्ट बनवाओगे
ठीक है
और आपका कॉन्सेप्ट ठीक है कि BSc 3 वाले भी न्यू है प्रोजेक्ट्स को लेके लेकिन उनकी थ्योरी में वो जो पढ़ चुके हैं लेट देम पुट यूज टू दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल अमाइनो एसिड्स बेसिक अमाइनो एसिड्स हमें बायोकेमिस्ट्री ऑनर्स के फर्स्ट ईयर में बताए गए थे स्ट्रक्चर ठीक है तो आइसोलेशन अगर हम तब करते हैं हमें मजा आता है बट वही चीज अगर आप फाइनल ईयर स्टूडेंट्स को बोलोगे करने के लिए जब वो सेपरेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन्स कर रहे हैं तो दे विल फाइंड इट वेरी बोरिंग आई मीन दे विल नॉट बी रियली इंटरेस्टेड सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच आई एम गिविंग यू विद एन एग्जांपल काइंडली वी ग्रुप इट एंड देन फ्रेज इट अकॉर्डिंगली
ओके मैम
ओके
जी सो And similarly, the Department of Chemistry, the grouping of Department of Chemistry, as per your suggestion, that is, they have made the groups of students of same class. So we have only planned this for these type of groups because I have already explained, and it is clear to as per your suggestion, we will change it. So these are the faculty improvement programs attended by the. Faculty members during this period of lockdown and for Department of Chemistry. So the impact after receiving DBT star DBT support, so that has already explained by Dr. Gurpreet sir. So in the Department of Physics, so there are 55 practicals experiments mentioned in the current curriculum of the university. But out of these 55 practicals, 17 practicals cannot be performed due to lack of fund before. But now we can perform 13 practicals from these 17 practicals and 4 practicals are still pending due to the costly equipment. So the new practicals are that will be introduced and the interdepartmental approach so that the viscosity and surface tension measurement of liquids and measurement of optical rotation for plane polarized light, determination of specific resistance of metallic wire and analysis of hydrogen spectrum and measurement of Planck's constant, capacitance, inductance, and resistance measurement measurement of particle absorption coefficient for metallic foil and verification of inverse square law for intensity of light. In addition to these 8 practicals, we have planned 25 innovative experiments that will be demonstrated in the form of an innovation hub. And in the Department of Chemistry, they have completed all the experiments mentioned in the syllabus. They have all the equipments, but they have also introduced new practicals that is a physicochemical analysis of water in the region, determine the presence of insecticides and pesticides in the foodstuff, specific and optical rotation in the optically active substance, measurement of EMF of electrochemical cells, variation of Lambert-Beer law, and determine the Muller refractivity of solids. So total we have 39 new practicals that we will introduce. We have planned to introduce before this COVID-19 situation, but as the situation will become normal, we will try to execute all these practicals in addition to the already mentioned practicals in the syllabus. So impact of the Star College scheme, that the interaction with the students has been improved by the online mode. Both departments, physics and chemistry, will be enriched with the equipments and books required for providing additional training to our students. It will improve equipment to student ratio as the multiple copies of equipments are going to be purchased. And student strength has been improved in BSc1 as mentioned by Dr. Mithu ma'am, and expected to improve in future also. Special strengths of our college: state-of-the-art instrumentation lab with FTIR UV visible spectrophotometer, rotatory vacuum evaporator, digital ultrasonicator, digital function generator, dark room equipped with the spectrometer and helium neon laser setup, Wi-Fi campus and ICT enabled classrooms, well stocked central library with InfliNet facility, so e-learning management system with Google Classroom, scholarships, financial aid financially weaker single girl child, meritorious students, parentless, fatherless students. MOU with Central University of Punjab, and we are trying to do the MOU with Maharaja Ranjit Singh Punjab Technical University. So good infrastructure with adequate number of laboratories and classrooms, seminar hall, auditorium, student center, RO unit, solar panel, botanical garden, etc. Future plan of activities: we will organize workshop on hands-on practicals after opening of this physical opening of colleges, and public lectures on awareness about chemicals in daily use, medicinal plants and household circuits. Inter-college competition for extracurricular activities like poster model and PPT making, debate and quiz. Excursion of research labs at nearby research institutes. Hands-on practical training to students for innovative experiments. Industrial visits to thermal power plant of Lara Mohabbat and oil refinery also. So this is the Star College tab on our website. Media coverage of our various activities like webinars, training or poster making competition. Our YouTube channel that we have created. So thank you, courtesy to Google Meet platform. Thank you, ma'am. No.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hello, Dr. Mohan. Haji, sir, we should go for queries and discussions.
Yes.
Yeah, Dr. Mohan, I think you are ready for the queries from our side. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
आपकी अगर आप second last slide लगा दीजिए अपने स्क्रीन पे तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा
जी मैम
सो दैट वी कैन इंटरैक्ट मोर फ्रीली दिस इज द सेकंड लास्ट स्लाइड वेयर यू आर गिविंग फ्यूचर
ओके
टीचर्स यू वुड बी डूइंग इन
ओके
आपने जो कुछ भी प्रेजेंट किया दैट बेस्ड ऑन अगर कॉलेजेस खुले हुए
प्लीज
और वही आपने अगर आप Can you hear me?
Ma'am, there is some distortion of your voice. Please repeat. Please repeat.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, now it is clear.
I'm saying that whatever you
Sorry, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
Oh my God.
Sorry, ma'am. I think there is a problem in Google Meet. It will work only for 1 hour. I will either we have to disconnect and reconnect it. I think there may be a problem. Hello. Hello.
I think we should disconnect and then reconnect, sir.
Okay, we
could because this will be the
device. Now your voice is clear, sir. Now it is clear. Hello.
मैडम की वॉइस क्लियर आ रही थी
हाँ हेलो
हेलो सैमसंग से लेकिन प्रोडक्ट से फोन चेंज कर
ओके 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 हेलो रीना मैडम नाउ इट आई थिंक इट इज ओके प्लीज कंटिन्यू
यस एंड इट
सो वॉइस
हेलो मैं आई कैन plans you are showing as future activities would only be possible if the colleges and the entire environment around you is open again.
Yes.
And it becomes safe for you to move here and thereabout. But as of now, when we are restricted to our homes and our workplaces and we can't meet in large numbers, we can't ask students to come over and have a physical demonstration or hands-on experience, then the best thing is that you encourage them for more home-based activities.
Yes.
So have more theme-based journal clubs, as I was saying, for both the departments. Plus, encourage them to write about projects which they would be able to do once the colleges reopen. Based on that, you can have quiz competitions, you can have poster making competitions, and more of project writing competitions.
Okay.
They cannot do projects right now, but they can think about the projects. They can think about innovative ideas which they would like to carry out in future when the colleges reopen. Based on that, you can assess your students. And also encourage them by giving them a few prizes.
Okay.
Dr. Rajiv Khosla would guide you very appropriately because he has done several such activities in his college. So maybe you should talk to him more often. Another thing which I found in your presentation was that you yourself say that you are the only college from your area which has been included under STAR.
Yes.
So it becomes your responsibility to mentor other colleges in your vicinity so that they apply for STAR college scheme and they get selected under the scheme.
Definitely, ma'am.
It is not that they will only apply and then they will get disqualified because they did not make a good presentation.
Yes.
So mentoring should be up to the level where they are strengthened enough to make a good presentation before the committee, as you have done, and they get selected for the scheme.
Okay.
So this can be done online. You don't have to physically meet. The way we are meeting right now, you can also have meetings and this will be a part of your outreach activity.
Okay.
Likewise, what another point which I found completely missing was that you have not proposed any interdisciplinary activities between the two participating departments.
So, yes.
Try to think on those lines.
Hmm.
And be very clear, careful that interdepartmental and interdisciplinary activities are very different. Okay.
Yes.
Interdepartmental is something you call four departments and they listen to a lecture. That is fine. But when interdisciplinary activity comes, that means expertise of the participating faculties are put to use so that they formulate a small project or a small activity for the students. where the students of both the departments get interested.
Okay.
One more thing that I found was something which was mentioned by your expert, who said that you need to have a very expensive equipment.
Yes.
Scintillation counter, I guess that was it?
Yes, ma'am. Scintillation counter.
Now, scintillation counter is of 4.5 lakhs.
Yes.
Have you decided what practicals would be conducted using that for the 3 years? First year, second year, third year?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have a list of practicals?
Yes, ma'am. These are the list. 15, 16 and 17 practical are the practicals done by the scintillation counter to study the energy resolution and calibration of scintillation counter.
Okay, okay, fine.
Yes.
My question is that are they a part of the syllabus?
Yes.
You say because so far you have not been able to conduct them.
Yes, ma'am.
So rather than waiting for a large grant to come in, why don't you ask your college management to chip in part fund and then maybe you can request DBT for part fund? Because we don't allow more than 3 lakhs. But if you use up to 3 lakhs and the rest 1.4 can be given by your college management, I think you can buy this equipment. But you should ensure, because we will ask you a list of equipments and projects that you would be conducting using this equipment. It's an expensive equipment. So only 3 practicals will not be sufficient to justify your claim that it is very important.
Okay.
On one hand, the result shown by the first presentation was depicting that the student number is going down. So first, your effort should be to strengthen that number so that the students are retained in the college, the admission number increases, the students remain with you and they get attracted. How will they do that? If you only strengthen the basic education rather than focusing on high-end equipments and conducting fancy equipments.
Naturally.
Let the basic knowledge be strengthened. And then you can think about these things.
Okay.
That was all from my part. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Yeah, adding on to what Dr. Garima has said, see, there has to be an optimum utilization of the scintillation counter. That is very important. See, if you're planning to buy a 4.5 lakh equipment, it should be used optimally. You have to now work backwards and see what will be the utility of this equipment if at all you're purchasing.
Actually, ma'am,
you need to do some groundwork and then plan to purchase if at all you want to do it.
Okay.
So, because these are the high-end equipments and there has to be a utility of these equipments.
Actually, ma'am, can I speak? Ma'am, as described by Dr. B.S. Sandhu, so these are the practicals mentioned in the B.Sc. final year syllabus. But when students got admission in the higher education institutes or like selected in the B.A.R.C. for any training, so they are supposed to get the familiar with this equipment as they have completed their UG from the PIB University.
But are you using the radioactivity in your colleges? You have to count the radioactivity.
Yes, ma'am. We already have GM counter in our lab and radioactive.
So that is the colony counter. That counter is different, but. Scintillation counter is a big equipment.
Yes, ma'am. It is a very important and delicate instrument that is very widely used in the study of the radioactivity. This is an essential equipment of a nuclear physics lab. We can say that.
Dr. Mann, can I add something?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
First of all, I would acknowledge the remarkable support from Dr. Meenakshi Munshi, with whom I met first time in the last DBT coordinator meet, and he listened to me patiently when I discussed a program AFSAR from DBT grant on popularization of biotechnology. And her remarkable interest really influenced me very much. Secondly, I would like to acknowledge Dr. Garima ma'am's support. I think untiring cooperation, support and incredible ideas. So I usually referred her as think tank of DBT Star College scheme, national level think tank. And her suggestions are really, every time when I listen to her, I personally feel I get some new suggestion, new ideas from
and
her.
Also, she's put in a lot of effort in this program.
Definitely, ma'am.
Putting a lot of hard work in seeing that this program is a success.
Success, definitely, ma'am, definitely. Dr. Mann, as ma'am suggested regarding the grouping of the students for the projects, you can organize or you can have an idea of organizing summer school project or winter school project when the conditions they come to normal. And there you can formulate interdisciplinary groups. You can take students from the first year, from medical stream, from non-medical stream, and that idea will really, when I applied this idea, I think twice during this program, that worked really very well. Because the cross-fertilization of idea and the cross-fertilization of thinking that developed during this process will give you, I think, a rich dividend in the form of scientific interest among the students. Secondly, sir, I would suggest strength problem is everywhere. In Punjab, the condition is very much scary for all of us due to several reasons. First of all, students primarily interest in the pre-medical and pre-engineering domain. And secondly, the NRI, phobia, which is going on. And the third is, the COVID situation, which has bent the financial additional constraints on the people. So I think focus on entry-level students and exit-level students. For entry-level students, you have to inculcate the ample interest. That can be done not only by formulating the projects, you can organize lab orientation program. In fact, the students at entry level must see what type of equipments are there, how would I run the equipment, how would I use the equipment? How would I maintain the equipment? That is very important. Similarly, for exit level student, if you want to maintain the interest, then you have to talk about some type of competitive exams wherever the students it can go for the higher study and pursue the interest. That chain is very important. So focus on entry level and exit level by organizing some additional programs which can serve the purpose. Third thing, sir, I think there are two types of practicals you have mentioned during your presentation. One, they are present in curriculum, but you cannot perform due to the lack of equipment or lack of infrastructure, whatever is there. And secondly, those practical which you want to additionally inculcate. But I think go for extension practical. The practical which you have already in the curriculum, you think over it, you extend it, you link it with some other two or three experiments. What will it do? It will generate the interest among the students. Your curriculum will not be affected. And the additional mileage which the students will get, that will be really remarkable. So extension practical, I think you should think over it. They will be very much helpful for you. Then, sir, try to introduce the green chemistry experiments much more. One of the ideas that I got from Dr. Garima Gupta, ma'am, during our advisory meeting, and that worked very well when we went for the presentation, because experts from the chemistry domains, they appreciated the idea. So you should go for green chemistry experiment, green chemistry projects, micro chemistry-based project. And for interdisciplinary, I will suggest go for biochemistry practical, where you involve biology and the chemistry students to perform the experiments, very simple experiments, I think. For example, the estimation of lipids, carbohydrates, then how will you purify the proteins or the different amino acids. So these are very small. Try, for example, you can ask your student to get some fresh juices and some packed juices like real juices and go for the vitamin C content or mineral content. It will be really interesting things for them. So it will be interdepartmental as well as interdisciplinary activities. Then you can go for ESOP. So today, because due to this COVID pandemic, the conditions are not user-friendly for us. So you can go for ESOP so that it will be accessible to all students. So these are few humble requests or you can say suggestions from my side. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. We have noted all the suggestions provided by you. These are very valuable suggestions. We will implement these suggestions in our future activities. हेलो हेलो आई एम ऑडिबल
यू आर ऑडिबल
यस सर यू आर
सो थैंक यू सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर वैल्यूएबल सजेशंस सो वी विल वी हैव नोटेड ऑल द सजेशंस गिवन बाय यू एंड वी डेफिनेटली इंक्लूड योर सजेशंस एंड एडवाइसेस इन आवर फ्यूचर एक्टिविटीज Over to Paramjit, ma'am.
Hello, sir. So we should take any inquiries or from our faculty, sir. You want to give something from ma'am?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Paramjit ma'am. Very good afternoon to Dr. Meenakshi and Dr. Garima and all the worthy members of this advisory committee. And very good afternoon to my colleagues. Am I audible to all?
Yes.
Okay. Actually, most of the queries are very well taken in the suggestions of Dr. Garima. So, with one or two queries, should I ask Dr. Garima and Dr. Meenakshi if you allow?
Yes. Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. My first query is basically it's a clarification. If one of our member is writing some SOP, should that project be given to only 4 student or should we distribute that experiment or project turn by turn to all the students?
Garima, you would like to answer this? Logically, I feel that
Garima,
you can answer this, and then I'll add.
No, ma'am, sorry. Dr. Malhotra, can you give your question again? Actually, there was a call and this, I couldn't hear it.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm asking, ma'am, if my teacher, my worthy colleague is writing some SOP on some project, should that SOP or project should be given only to 4 or 5 students in a group, or we should distribute that experiment turn by turn to all the to all the students?
No, I feel SOPs once made and validated by a group of students can be used by others. There is no issue in that. So, in fact, we encourage people, I mean colleges, to compile SOPs that have been framed by them over years and then validate them and put them in the form of a manual.
Right. Thank you, ma'am. And another one, actually in the Department of Chemistry, we sanctioned 15 SOPs already. So can we add more SOPs at this stage?
Yes, you can add. You can keep on adding more SOPs over years. And finally, these SOPs can also be put on your college website for all the students to access them freely and use them.
Right, thank you. And one more query, ma'am. Actually, from the SOP, we require 4 instruments and we are in a process of communication with you regarding 4 instruments. Is it a right time to ask you the status of those 4 extra instruments?
No, I understand that. I am aware that you are asking for some equipments which are either a replacement of the previously requested one in the proposal. We are still sorting that out. It will take a few days.
Right. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah,
so, if any worthy member want to ask any question, he or she may ask.
Hello.
Yes, Dr. Ma'am.
There is one query from my side and also from our principal, sir, that is there any flexibility due to COVID-19 situation in the utilization of the grant? from the department?
There is no flexibility as such, but everybody understands that due to COVID, work has been stuck up in all the colleges. So this is going to be universal. Whatever stand will be taken will be universal. But that does not mean that you should stop doing anything. You should continue doing your efforts online, and whatever you have proposed, it was quite good. The money, you should not worry at the moment. Okay. Even if there is an issue in spending the money, that will be taken care of in future. So your worry should not be about the money. Your worry should be about how to conduct as much as things possible for the student under the scheme. That's all.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Any other query from my colleagues?
No, sir. So, I think all our queries have been discussed already.
Okay. So now over to Dr. Gurpi sir for a vote of thanks. Can I? Sorry, 1 minute, ma'am. Can we conclude or is something is pending?
Yeah, I mean, if there is nothing else pending, and then we can certainly conclude.
Okay. Thank you. Over to Dr. Gurpi sir for vote of thanks.
Respected Dr. Meenakshi Munshi, Advisor HRD DBT, Dr. Garima Gupta, Program Officer DBT Star College Scheme, Worthy Principal Professor Praveen Kumar Garg, Dr. B.S. Sandhu, Professor and Head Department of Physics, Punjabi University, Patiala, Dr. Rajiv Khosla, Head Department of Biotechnology, Dwaba College, Jalandhar. Good afternoon to all of you. It is my pride and privilege to propose a vote of thanks on the occasion of meeting of Advisory Committee of DBT for the smooth implementation of DBT Star College Scheme of DAV College, Bathinda. I am sincerely thankful to the advisor, HRD Dr. Meenakshi Munshi, and Program Officer Dr. Garima Gupta, for giving their valuable suggestions regarding projects and experiments for the smooth implementation of the scheme. I am thankful to Dr. B.S. Sandhu, Head Department of Physics, Punjabi University, Patiala, for his inspiring suggestions. I am also thankful to Dr. Rajiv Khosla, Head Department of Biotechnology, Dwaba College, Jalandhar, for his valuable suggestions and unwavering support. I take this opportunity to thank our principal, Professor Praveen Kumar Garg, for all-out cooperation in implementing this scheme. So my thanks to all the members of the Department of Physics and Chemistry who have given their precious time in organizing this meeting. So I once again thank everyone for their contribution in this meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Hello.
Thank you,
Jeev sir. Thank you, Grima ma'am. Thanks, Makshi ma'am. And thank you all.
Thank you.
Yes? Hello. Praveen sir, thank you. So we can...
Thank you, everybody.
Thanks a lot. Okay, sir, thank you.